Om Shanti. Let's welcome Sister Shilu with one hand clap. Thank you for being here in our first session of this Silence Bhati. The theme for today is freedom. And Shilu Ben will be talking on the power of silence to be free. And someone asked me if this program is only for those observing silence. So just to clarify that in the next 3 days, this is general program for everyone, those observing silence and those that are not observing silence, because everyone will benefit from all these sessions. So Shilu Ben will share with us now. Om Shanti.
Om Shanti. Om Shanti. Om Shanti. Can we observe silence even when we come in sound? Can we experience silence or observe silence even when we come in sound? The answer is yes. Even when we come in sound, we can still experience silence. And even if we are in silence, we can still be experiencing noise. But that is a very different subject. I have been told to speak on the power of silence to be free. Silence is a great power. Today, we all talk about power. What exactly is power? And how silence is a power, and how it frees us. It helps us to stay beyond. In order to define power, we have to give some words. So power could be defined as something which moves, something which pulls, something which pushes, something which attracts, something which holds, something which changes. All this can be defined under one term, power. So power is that which brings about a transformation. In one word, something which brings about transformation is something which is power. If the transformation is not coming, it's definitely not a power. But there are two types of transformations, or you can say two types of powers. The physical power and the spiritual power. It could also be defined as, in a different way, two types of powers, positive power and negative power. But here we are talking about the power of silence. So how the power of silence brings about a transformation and enables us to go beyond. to stay beyond. Beyond what? And then how? Silence is not defined as no noise. No noise or no sound doesn't mean silence. It can't be defined in a negative way because it's a power. It's not lack of something. Just like light is power, but it can't be defined as absence of darkness because light is energy. Yes, darkness is no power, no energy, and therefore it can be defined as absence of light. But light can't be defined as absence of darkness. Light has a source. Darkness does not have any source. So anything which changes, which transforms, is definitely a power. And silence is a very big power. It brings about a very big transformation. It is said, speech is silver and silence is gold. In speech there is sound, but that is compared to silver. But silence is gold. It is much more expensive, much more dearer, much more powerful. So as it cannot be defined as something which is absence of sound, absence of noise, absence of something, is definitely a very big presence. Because it has a source. The source is the soul itself. The source is the Supreme Being. The source is our sweet home, the world of silence. Silence could be also called deep silence, dead silence, sweet silence. And that silence which comes about after the sound brings about the transformation. When we go into deep silence, the soul is able to reveal its true self. Silence acts like a mirror where the soul is able to see itself, to reveal its own self, to attain its original state of being. It gives me a clear understanding of who am I, who my father is, and what am I supposed to do. And once I know that, I'm able to become free. What does it mean to become free? It means to become stable. It also means to let go. It also means to have no pulls and pushes, to have no attractions. It means going beyond. So when I am in that state of silence, the realization comes of my true self. When I am in my true home, totally free, free from opposites. In this world, everything is relative. And because everything is relative, there is a lot of comparison. This is more silent than that. This is less silent than that. But when it is absolute, there is no comparison. Just as God is called absolute, no comparison. But every soul, although it is not absolute, there are comparisons. Souls can be compared, but still, every soul is also unique. And because it is unique, it cannot be compared. And because it cannot be compared, it is able to experience its true self in its true way. And this is what the power of silence gives us the experience of. Where the soul is able to experience its true nature. No pulls of this physical world. Neither the negative pull nor the positive pull. The negative pull could be in the form of defects of somebody. The positive pull could be in the form of virtues of somebody. And if I see the defects and I'm affected by those defects, then negatively, then surely I will feel sorrow. If I'm attracted by someone's virtues, then that will give me pleasure maybe for a short while. The defects or weaknesses of somebody may give me pain. But power of silence means going beyond pain and pleasure, where neither negativity attracts me nor positivity attracts me. So neither pain nor pleasure affects me. This is what we call as the state of equanimity. This is what is called as a state of equilibrium, in total equilibrium. Just like in a pendulum, just like in a scale, there is an equal balance. No extra pull from any end, or no extra push from any end, but equal, unbiased, unaffected. And that is possible only when I am beyond the pull of the body. The pull of the body brings about the attraction and the repulsion. But when the soul is beyond the pull of the body, the soul is beyond any attractions or repulsions. It has gone beyond. Beyond the opposites of this world. What people in the world desire for liberation, freedom. When they talk about freedom, what do they mean by freedom? People really don't understand the true meaning of freedom. On the name of freedom, people are binding themselves in different bondages, in the bondages of their sense organs. They don't know what it means to be bodiless. But all on the name of freedom, their senses are pulling them, and they think that is freedom. I can eat what I like, I can see what I like, I can do what I like, I am free. But those senses are actually binding them, and they become a slave of their senses. But then on the other hand, as we follow the disciplines, as we follow the maryadas, the principles, the Srimat which Baba gives, we remain within the line of code of conduct. We know what is good or what is bad for the soul. We do according to what is right for me. We do everything under the instructions of the Supreme. It may seem to be a bondage, because sometimes we may think it is too much. How can I make myself so strict in these rules and regulations, in so many disciplines? But actually, what may seem to be a bondage is actually helping me to attain freedom. It is helping me to go beyond, to be really free from the pull of matter. Because matter is that which binds. In the world of souls, in our true sweet home, there is no matter. But no elements, it doesn't really mean that it is a dead state. It doesn't really mean that the soul is totally like a piece of wood or piece of stone. It is very much living. It's very much sentient and conscient. But yes, the experience of that is had only when we come in the physical body. Like when one is in a deep sleep stage, that deep sleep stage is total freedom. But doesn't mean a dead stage. the person is very much alive. It's a sweet sleep stage. But then at that moment, one is not able to feel that experience. But only when one wakes up, he realizes, oh, I had such good sleep. It was wonderful. So that experience of deep sleep, the experience of relief, the experience of freedom is felt only when we wake up. Although it is there in that deep sleep stage. So too, when the soul is in the soul world, definitely at that moment there may not be an experience. You won't say it. Just like when one is in deep sleep, he won't say, oh, I'm enjoying my deep sleep. I'm in such deep bliss. I'm enjoying it. No. But when he wakes up, he said, I really enjoyed my sleep. I feel so fresh, so alert, totally awakened. So too, when the soul is in the soul world, that's a state of total freedom. It's not a state of vacuum or state of void, but it's a state of freedom. But that experience of freedom can be had in our state of meditation. When the soul is in the body and yet it is beyond the body. It can also be in the angelic stage. It can also be in the seed stage. And it can also be in a karma yogi stage, where the soul is performing the actions and yet it is not being affected by those actions. The imprints of those actions are not affecting the soul. In a second, it can go beyond. Usually we feel whenever we are doing some actions and when we have to change those actions, the first impression, the impression of the previous actions, doesn't go very easily. I'm doing something else, but I'm remembering something else. That means the impressions or the imprints of my previous actions are still there, which I did earlier. Now I'm doing something else. But I'm remembering that. That's why it is said sometimes we think differently, we speak differently, we do differently, you know, very often. When somebody is in a state of confusion, he's thinking something else. But he's saying something else and he's doing something else. All the three have no alignment. But then, when we are in a state of meditation, although the actions are there, the words are there, the thoughts are there, but they are all in alignment. And that is why we get success. We are in the total state of concentration, doing those actions in Baba's remembrance. And then we can go beyond the impact or the impressions of those actions in a second. There will not be any question whether I did it well or not well, whether it was good or not good, whether I will get success or not get success. No questions, no doubts, no fear. But definitely, it was the best I could do. I could not think of anything better. And so that gives me true freedom. Because I feel that yes, I did it in Baba's remembrance. And whatever the result, it's up to Baba. So I'm not affected. And I can go beyond in a second. This is called freedom. Whether someone praises me or defames me, it makes no difference to me. I remain unaffected. Usually it happens that when somebody praises me, I feel like inflated, you know, like an inflated balloon. But when somebody defames me, I feel that I'm totally depleted, completely finished, my energy is lost, my power is gone. So my inner power depends on somebody else. Well, that is not freedom, because I become dependent. So true freedom is experienced in the power of silence. When the soul is beyond these pulls and pushes, and attractions and repulsions, it can hold itself on its own without anyone else's hold on it. So this is what we have to experience today. Total freedom. Being beyond. Completely free. So for the next half an hour, let us experience this and fill in the self so much power, so that the soul is able to attain its original state of being. I don't have to struggle. I don't have to battle. I don't have to be confused. I'm totally free. So let us experience this. In a second, I can go beyond the pull of matter. I am neither this body nor am I this role I am playing. I have played so many roles in so many bodies. Each role different from the other. Each body different from the other. I I change my costumes, I change my roles. And came down the ladder. I lost my purity. I lost my peace. I lost my inner strength. Now I know how to get it back. By experiencing the deep power of silence. Which enables me to attain my true nature back. Soul in total silence. Beyond any type of questions. Totally satisfied. Nothing can pull this soul. I am a powerful soul. In the company of the Almighty Father, nothing of the old world attracts me. People, objects, places. I can go beyond them in a second. I go into the depth of my own true self. can experience true silence within. I'm so light. I'm so clean within. I'm so pure within. Purity, peace, power, these are my birthright. Which I claim from the Father. How pure I am. How peaceful I am. How powerful I am. I am now aware of my true self. In the company of my Supreme Father, I become his instrument. And reflect all my inner powers out into the world. This huge cosmos, universe, getting the vibrations of purity, peace, and power through my true state of freedom. Sweetest Baba, I feel myself to be so free, so light, so detached. Just like you. Promise, Baba, that I will always stay this way. Even when I come into action, even when I come into words, in this state of freedom, I am a bestower. I am the benefactor. I become your helper and help the souls of the world so that they may also become free like me. I'm able to finish all my weaknesses. Face with my highest Father. Appoint in divine form an endless, fathomless, in His powers. I go deep into the ocean of silence. Externally, there may be many sounds, but those sounds don't affect me. I am in deep silence. Absorbing myself into the ocean of